Hello and welcome to the second episode of the Viva Football Show. As we promised to explore the Indian football map, today we'll be traveling to the various academies in India, in Mumbai and Himachal Pradesh, and in the beautiful city of Rajasthan, Udaipur.
Hello friends, we are back again and as promised with one more new passionate guest who is like done a beautiful job for football. Right away, playing in Kerala, going all the way to Netherlands to have a football coaching certificate, then coming back, going to Himachal Pradesh, working as a as their head coach and chief technical officer, and to Mumbai, founder of Braveheart Football School. So I warmly welcome Mr. Sudhir on this Viva Football Show.
Thank you, Mr. Ashish. It's a big honor to be in this show, one of my special moments in my life, because this is the first interview here in Bombay. Yeah. It's a big honor to part of. I'm a fan of Ms. Ashish and also Viva Football. Life experience.
Yeah, it's my pleasure. Basically, both of us share the same passion, that is football, and that's why we talk hours and hours on football. So I thought just connect on through our show. So Mr. Sudhir, just tell me about your journey from Kerala to Netherlands football coaching and then Himachal. How it all happened over the years?
First of all, I'm, as you knew, Keralites, we are passionate on football.
Yes.
And from my childhood, because we had a lot of good department teams. Hmm. Example, I am coming from south of Kerala, a place called Kollam.
Okay.
Kollam, there is a town called Kundara. In 60s and 70s, there was a top football club in India called Alinch Kundara. So, I am coming from that place. We have football in our blood. So, we are watching them childhood. We train under them. So, that was into our blood. So be fully passionate in football. After that, I done my graduation and post-graduation. Then I played district and state and level. And afterwards, I tried to help my coach in coaching.
Oh,
I realized football is a strong, efficient tool to teach the kids the values in life.
Absolutely.
Football, of course. Can in football, there are many others. It is deeply connected, resemblance of life, also it is connected with life.
Yeah.
So for me, football is not a kicking ball. It's a, for me, it's a scientific way, it's a mixture of physics, mathematics, and psychology.
Okay.
So it's a love. And after this, I done my MIS in Calcutta side.
Oh.
Then I tried my best to learn from my coach. Then I got an offer from Himachal Pradesh Football Association because the General Secretary, Deepa Sharma sir, he is also an NIS coach. He's also an NIS coach who is also the General Secretary of State Football Association.
Okay.
But before that, I got a chance. I attended an international football coaching certificate course in Netherlands.
Oh.
So that was next. Because from my childhood, I was mad on Dutch football. It is also deeply connected with my hometown, that is home district Kollam. Kollam was also a Dutch colony.
Oh, yeah.
So my grandfather also connected with that all.
Achha.
So I was mad on Dutch people. So I don't know if you knew. You knew of course young guys, but I was mad on one player called Arie Han.
Ah. Okay.
He played in the 74 World Cup and 78 World Cup. So
under Johan Cruyff.
So my papa's sister, she was in North Germany. So she helped me to get the videos. So in video cassettes.
Yeah.
In the 80s,
yeah. Yes.
I was not football full time. Only one vaccine is sports stuff.
Yeah.
Every day, reading, watching, playing football in our stadium, Labrador Stadium.
Yeah.
So, afterwards, I got a chance to tell you that certificate code. Then, I thought, why can't I try for UEFA diploma?
Okay.
That is a challenge. First thing, I should live there, I should coach there, I should speak, but it was a biggest challenge.
Yes.
But crazy, I took the challenge.
Mm-hmm.
Always keep in your mind, hard work with God's grace, we can achieve.
Yeah, absolutely.
There are many talented students or coaches that can go higher.
Yeah.
Do you have a real hunger and passion?
Yeah, absolutely. Lot of footballers have achieved their dream through hard work and believing themselves. So that's true.
Yes. And God's grace. That's Allah.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's why Brazilian people.
Yes. So then I got an invitation from Himachal Pradesh Football Union in 2011.
Okay.
So director invited me. Come on, Sudhir, just come and visit Himachal. Top coach, he's well known, and then he asked me to coach. Come on, coach the Sunday Shopee team 2012. It was in Qatar. One of the best experience.
Yeah, and coming to Bravehearts Academy, like Mumbai, Malad, Western suburb of Mumbai. So, and the kids, right from the age group of 6, they train under you at Bravehearts. So, how is it? Five. Okay.
Yeah. And the Bravehearts started in Kerala.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I came to Mumbai in 2008.
Okay.
Because of God, that time, I got a job as an administrator of Mumbai District Football Association.
Oh, Parel. That time, Parel was the... MDF.
So, Sota was for the general secretary.
Okay.
Yeah. So, after 1 year, I got an offer to be in one academy. Then I got into Malad.
Acha.
But after 2010, we started our own Bravehearts football team.
Okay. So, how you see the kids, like from Kerala to Himachal to Mumbai? So, how is the enthusiasm and the passion for football in the kids?
Everywhere human is same. Don't get confused. Only cultural conditions are different. In this world, only three things are universal. One is love, one is music, one is football. Everywhere we can play.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. True.
The thing is, how do we connect with the students? How do we connect with the football? That's the real call.
Exactly.
Imagine the first training I did, they don't speak Hindi, they speak Punjabi and Pahadi. I don't speak Hindi. It was interesting. So, Bravehearts in Mumbai 2010 we started. So, currently we are the champions in Mumbai City, which is Baby League under 10 category.
Okay.
It's a hard work.
Yeah, absolutely.
We don't take the players, students in the academy. We want parents interview. They know that we are taking.
Exactly. So, that's where I was coming. Like for a kid of age of say 5, 6 and 10, parents' role is very crucial. So, how you communicate with the parents? How you get their support out of parents?
Parents should come for the interview. They have a board. We have a particular question. We have a formal talk and friendly talk. Then father and mother, I like to know what their perception about sports in their life. Why do they need to put this boy in the post?
Okay.
So we made a category. One is competitive group. One is group. One is promising group.
Okay.
Because Bravehearts have a in the perception about football.
Acha.
So we have our own methods. And we don't take any coaches from outside. We have a coaches who play for Bravehearts He passed his licenses. They are coaching.
Okay. And what about Himachal? Himachal, so we know Shimla, Kulu, Manali, that's only we know about Himachal. But football in Himachal, how is the football in the hills?
Oh, Himachal boys are highly talented. You don't believe it.
Yeah.
Highly talented. But the difficulty is the geographical condition.
Absolutely. Yeah. Very different, very difficult terrain over there. Yeah.
But the strange way, very strange way, if you go to Himachal, every district you can see a top cricket academy.
Oh, okay.
So, okay. So now our association is very solid. We are doing hard work. Now okay. We have two professional clubs.
One
is Pradesh and Shimla.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
I don't know if you knew the another one, sorry. The last under 15 AFF champions, women. Himachal is the champions.
Yes, I know. So there is a lot of women's football activities also on in Himachal recently. Yeah, you have your own state league also for women's football.
Yeah. The leadership of our general secretary, the future plan, he's a hard worker. He's not a businessman. He's full time in the government. He's also physical education, working in the department.
Okay.
And we have a good structure right now. Now our plan is starting at grassroots level, the baby league, also club leagues. My task right now is baby league and amateur football club networking.
That's true.
The amateur club.
That's true.
So
yeah.
How can and help us help the clubs support?
Yeah.
So we are trying.
Yeah.
So HBA is going to have our own ground now.
Okay.
So Kangra.
Kangra, yeah. That's the headquarter for Himachal Pradesh football. Yeah.
So, company headquarters is Pune.
Okay.
Pune.
Okay.
And this is one.
And
please come and visit. But don't go crazy. Full of football.
Okay.
You can see that district is full of. So, border of Himachal and Chandigarh.
Okay. And no wonder your kids are such enthusiastic football lovers, because they have expressed themselves so generously and so liberally regarding Euro 2020, their favorite team and favorite player. So, coming to Euro, I'm sure Holland must be your favorite.
My favorite?
Yeah.
I saw these all World Cup players, how they are. They are in my blood. I'm fully into that. I believe they will come into state final.
Okay. But if you consider Holland, then barring 1988, that Marco van Basten superb goal and Ruud Gullit and Frank Rijkaard, that trio's triumph. Apart from 88 victory, Hollands are always best losers. So why is it so? And would that change in this year's Euro?
Please don't forget, when Cruyff was playing, Holland couldn't win. Remember, two World Cup. For me, winning is a luck factor too. There is a record. John Miesgens against West Germany. West Germany players didn't touch the ball. The first moment. So that's high talent. But the thing is also the luck factor.
Okay. But in this year's Euro, who will shine for the Dutch team?
Sorry, I don't follow any other country than Dutch.
Okay. But as far as Holland is concerned, we don't find any global stars like Ronaldo or Mbappe or Bale or anybody in the Dutch team.
Our team is very good. They lost against Germany last week.
Yes. Yeah.
Very good side. The coach changed the formation 5-3-2. So that is not a the that's permission, really.
Yeah, that's.
We always the one.
But two
and don't compare with the Marco and the Luke Gates era. Yeah, beyond.
Uh-huh.
I'm sure you saw the match of 80th Euro Cup.
Yeah. Holland Russia. Yeah, final. Absolutely.
But very interesting match was they played against Germany.
Semi-final. Yeah. That was a crucial match. Yeah, absolutely. That Rudy Waller and Frank Rijkaard incidents. That was that match.
My experience when I meet these all World Cup, they are very humble.
Yeah.
They are very caring.
That's true.
When we come into India, it's an endeavor. But I'm so happy I could share with you.
Apart from Holland, which other teams would make it to semi-final, according to you?
Germany.
Okay. England and France?
France is France. But I am observing my team is Hungary. I am observing them.
Okay. So they would be like underdogs for this.
Maybe. Because they are all the players are playing at top clubs. Uh-huh. They are performing them. Okay. They are not easy.
Okay. And would there be... Sorry?
Pardon?
Would there be any single superstar for this Euro? Like Ronaldo had it last year.
No. But Sweden have one striker.
Uh-huh.
Sweden is also a good side.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because Ibrahimovic is not playing. You know one Swedish top striker played for World Cup and
Ibrahimovic.
Hendrik.
Ibrahimovic.
No. Hendrik Larsson.
Hendrik Larsson. Yeah. Hendrik Larsson. Yeah. In the 90s. That's true.
He's playing for Russia. So they are also good side.
Good.
Can't say anything. Very good challenge. Good. And Viva will give you any special edition for.
Yeah. We were planning actually, but we were juggling amidst the lockdown. Now we have opened up. So we are planning to squeeze in some 20-24 pages edition before this Euro kickoff. So let's see. I'll share it to you for sure. And that's why we have found. Yeah, that's why we have this Viva Football Show. And there we interview you and your kids also have. Shown a great enthusiasm in sharing their views about Euro. So that's why that's the best way forward.
Some more also send it to me. I was little seeing shy to send you back. Some more points. I thought that you might think, what is this all?
So
all of them we train. Under 10 competitive team and under 12 competitive team. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, okay, so this was Mr. Sudhir, a very enthusiastic and passionate football coach. And I'm sure you must have enjoyed this episode. And also, you will enjoy the Euro 2020 predictions made by Bravehearts School, Football School. Kids, thank you. So that was Mr. Sudhir, very enthusiastic, passionate and knowledgeable football coach from Braveheart Academy and Himachal Pradesh Football Association. And now let's see which country Braveheart Academy kids follow and who is their favorite football player in this Euro 2020.
Hello. My name is Jayvardhan Gupta and I play for Bravehearts Football School, Mumbai. My favorite player is Manuel Neuer from Germany, the best goalkeeper in the world. My favorite team is Germany, and I am sure that they will win the Euro 2020 as they have a strong team and the best goalkeeper in the world.
Hi, my name is Devas Patel and I play for Bravehearts Football School, Malad in Mumbai. I think Portugal is going to win the Euro 2020 because it's a really strong team. My favorite star is Ronaldo.
Hello, my name is Shaurya Shirali. I play for the Bravehearts Football School in Malad. My favorite player is Paul Pogba and he plays for France. I think so France will win the Euro 2020 because they have a good squad.
Hello, my name is Arjunath Saxena. I play for Bravehearts Mumbai. I support Portugal in the Euro Cup and because my favorite player is in that team. The Cristiano Ronaldo. I think Portugal will win the cup. Love you, Ronaldo.
I am Lakshmindra. I play for the Bravehearts team, Mumbai, Malad West. My favorite player is Marcus Rashford. He plays for the England team. And I think England will win the Euro 2020 because they have the best players. Thank you.
My name is Sanjay D'Souza and I'm proud to be a part of Bravehearts Football School. My favorite player is Cristiano Ronaldo and he plays for Portugal. Ronaldo's team will win the Euro 2020. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Zenit. I play in Bravehearts, Mumbai. My favorite team is France. My favorite player is Mbappe. Bye.
Hello, my name is Taha. I play for Bravehearts Football School. In Mumbai, my favorite team is Portugal. I think Portugal will win 2020 Euro Cup because it has my favorite player, Cristiano Ronaldo. All the best, Portugal. Love you, Cristiano Ronaldo.
Hello, my name is Shlok Pithani. I play for Bravehearts Football School in Mumbai. I support France as my favorite player. Kylian Mbappe plays for that team. Thank you.
Hello everyone. My name is Joseph Jacob. I play for the Bravehearts Football School at Malad. My favorite player is Cristiano Ronaldo. He plays for Portugal. I think Portugal will win Euro 2020 because it is a very strong team. Thank you.
And as promised to you, from Himachal Pradesh, now we will travel all across to Rajasthan, to Udaipur.
So just like these cute little kids, I hope that you have decided your favorite team for the Euro 2020 and obviously your favorite player you are going to be supporting in this tournament. And don't miss the Euro special show on Friday. Subscribe for the new digital avatar of Viva Football, the Viva Football Show. And also for detailed content, don't forget to subscribe for our magazine, Viva Football Magazine, which is India's only football magazine in print format. See you on Friday. The countdown for Euro 2020 has begun. Adios.